respected principal sir, teachers, and my dear friends, a very good morning to one and all. I am Shraddha of class 8. Today is the most notable day in the history of our country. Yes, today we are celebrating National Science Day. I feel extremely honored to have such a great opportunity to speak about the National Science Day. The main objective of National Science Day is to bring awareness to people about the importance of science in our daily life and to encourage people by popularizing science and technology. Every year, the day is celebrated with a particular theme. This year, 2021, theme is Future of Science, Technology and Innovation. It impacts on education, skills and work. Generally, this celebration includes public speech, talk shows, science exhibition based on themes and concepts, live projects and researchers' demonstration, along with debates, quizzes, lectures and much more science-related activities. Also, various awards are given by government and non-government bodies to recognize the efforts of individuals for the popularization of science in the country. National Science Day is celebrated since 1987 on February 28 every year across India. Events on this day remind the importance of science, inspiring people of all ages to work in the field of science. This day attracts many young minds and motivates them to take up science as their career. The celebration of this day includes showcasing the country's competence in the field of science. National Science Day is also known as Rashtriya Vigyan Divas. But do you really know why do we celebrate this day? The National Science Day commemorates the invention of the Raman effect by the great Indian physicist of all times, Sir Chandrasekhar Venkat Raman. Sir Raman, on the same date, had invented the Raman effect in the year 1928. For his contribution in the field of science, Sir Raman was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physics in the year 1930. By celebrating this day as National Science Day, we show our dignity and respect to the famous Indian physicist for his contribution in the field of science. Sir C.V. Raman was born on November 7, 1888 at Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. His father was a lecturer in physics and maths. He studied in St. Andrews' Anglo-Indian School, Vishakhapatnam and Presidency College, Madras. In 1904, he obtained a BSc degree from the University of Madras, where he stood first and won the gold medal in physics. In 1907, he completed an MSc at the University of Madras with highest distinction. From 1907 and 1933, he worked in Kolkata at the Indian Association for the Cultivation of Science, doing research on various topics in physics. On February 28, 1928, Raman led an experiment with Indian physicist K.S. Krishnan on the scattering of light when he discovered what is now called the Raman effect. Raman effect explains the scattering of light when passing through the different materials. At least 25 variations of Raman spectroscopy have been developed. Raman analysis can provide key information easily and quickly. It can be used to rapidly characterize the chemical composition and structure of a sample, whether solid, liquid, gas, gel, slurry or powder. In fact, any application where non-destructive, microscopic, chemical analysis and imaging is required. Therefore, Raman spectroscopy is used in the advancement in the field of science, medicine and engineering. We use Raman spectroscopy to detect explosives to save millions of lives in every hour. We use the Raman spectroscopy to preserve the valuable historical artifacts too. After his retirement, Sir C.V. Raman established the Raman Research Institute in Bangalore. As students, it is our responsibility to honor the great man and his invention by contributing greatly to the field of science through innovation. I wish all the scientific enthusiasts very best to enhance their scientific zeal. Let us celebrate this day with various activities performed by our friends. Thank you and have a nice day.
Namaste, ma'am and sir. My name is Amalek, studying in UKG class. Today I am going to say about science. Let's do science. Let's do science. Writing the predictions, adjust the equipment, making preparation for my experiment. Solving our equations, observing reactions. I need concentration for my experiment. Let's do science. Let's do science. Welcome, welcome to our laboratory. Welcome.
Everyone, my name is Druti. I study in first class. Today I'm going to talk about three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. If solid, it doesn't change shape. It can't move around. It stays in one place. Your desk is solid. So is your chair. Look around your classroom. Whoa! It's everywhere. Now liquid. A liquid moves smoothly. We say that it flows from one place to another. How quickly it goes. We know that most liquids are easy to see, but with no shape of their own, they're not like you and me. Now gas. It is a gas which we can't see, that's true. But often we feel it in things that we do. Air rolls up a kite. Air fills a bubble. Without it, to breathe, we could be in big trouble. Thank you, everyone. Hope you enjoyed my video.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Karan Prakash. I'm studying in class 1. Today, I'm going to tell you about water cycle, the cyclic process of evaporation of water from Earth's surface followed by its condensation is called water cycle. Water cycle starts with evaporation. Water from ocean, seas, rivers and lakes changes into vapor as it evaporates. This vapor rises up in the atmosphere. This vapor goes very high and get cold and change into very tiny water droplets. This way clouds are formed. As more and more water vapors condense, the drops of the clouds, water clouds get bigger and bigger. They finally fall on Earth as rain. This rain water goes back to the seas and rivers. From there it again gets evaporated by the heat of the sun and the process starts all over again. Thank you.
Harsha Kevin, I'm studying in second class. Today I'm going to show an experiment on liquid pressure. I took two bottles. Made holes all around the bottle at the same height. I'm pouring water in the bottle. The water is coming out in equal distance. With different heights. To the other bottle also, I am keeping water. In this hole, the water is coming by the maximum speed. In this hole, the water is coming by the minimum speed. Water pressure increases if we go deeper in the water. Thank you.
Hi friends, my name is Pragya. I'm studying second class in DAV Public School. Today I'm going to do a science experiment. The experiment is density of water. For this experiment we need 2 glasses, lemon, salt and water. First we have to pour water in the 2 glasses. Next, we have to take 1 lemon and put it in the glass. It's sinking because lemon has higher density than density of water. That's why it's sinking. Next glass, we have to take 2 spoons of salt. We have to mix it when it dissolves. Next, we have to take the lemon and put it. It's floating because salt water makes higher density than density of lemon. That's why it's floating. Thank you, friends.
Hi, friends. We are from third class. Today, we are going to sing Science Day song.
From this experiment, we can conclude that when air or water has impurities,
impact of light is visible. If the particle size is bigger, the scattering will be more. Hope you enjoyed my video. Thank you.
Good morning to our principal, sir, teachers and my dear friends. I am Chakradhan and I am studying in class 5 DAV school, IITH, Hyderabad campus. Today I am going to show a set of experiments which explain the properties of the magnets. Magnets have the following properties. Magnets attract magnetic material towards itself. Materials made of iron, nickel and cobalt are generally magnetic in nature. Permanent magnets are made using these metals.
This is a ring magnet. Today I am going to show you non-magnetic and magnetic materials. This is a non-magnetic material. This is also a non-magnetic material. This is a magnetic material. This is also a magnetic material.
Our directional properties. A freely suspended ball magnet always aligns in north-south direction. Magnetic compass is used to find directions. Like poles repel each other and unlike poles attract each other.
Place the ball magnets on a white sheet in such a way that like poles are facing each other. Sprinkle the iron filings on the white sheet. You will observe that the iron filings between the bar magnets appear to be pushing away from each other. Now let us change the position of the second bar magnet so that unlike poles are facing each other. Sprinkle the iron filings on the white sheet. What do we observe? Yes, the iron filings between the bar magnets appear to be pulling towards each other.
The property of magnet is being used in Shanghai-Mangalore train which travels at a speed of 431 km per hour. This is called magnetic levitation. The bar magnet is rubbed over an iron bar. It changes the iron bar into a magnet. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Hello, my name is Ashwina and I am from class 6. Today, I am going to explain in detail about the human respiratory system. Air enters the respiratory system through the nose or the mouth. Do you know how air gets purified in the respiratory system? Yes, tiny hairs called cilia protect the nasal passageways and other parts of the respiratory system by filtering out dust and other particles that enter the nose to the deep there. The larynx or the voice box is the topmost part of the aerobic pipe. This small tube contains a pair of vocal cords which vibrate to make sounds. Trachea or the windpipe is a continuation of the airway below the larynx. The walls of trachea are strengthened with stiff rings of cartilage which help to keep it open. The trachea is also lined with cilia which sweep fluids and other foreign particles out so that they stay out of the lungs. In the lungs, the bronchi branch into smaller bronchi and even smaller air tubes called bronchioles. The bronchioles end into tiny air sacs called alveoli where the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide actually takes place. Each person has hundreds of millions of alveoli in their lungs. This network of alveoli, bronchioles and bronchi is known as the bronchial tree. Also contain elastic tissues which help them to inflate and deflate without losing shape and are also lined with a thin lining called pleura. Diaphragm, located below the lungs, is a major muscle of respiration. During inhalation, the diaphragm contracts and the chest cavity expands. During exhalation, the diaphragm relaxes and gets to its dome-like shape. I hope you like this video.
Good morning to our respected principal, sir, teachers and my dear friends. My name is Catherine and I am studying in class 7. Today I am going to tell some interesting facts about electric discharge. Experiencing a static current or electricity is not uncommon. Sometimes touching a door knob or a chair might give us a light electric jerk. But why do we feel this electric discharge? Everything we see around us is made up of atoms. They contain of positively charged protons, negatively charged electrons and neutral neutrons. Most of the atoms remain neutral. But when an atom has protons and electrons in odd numbers, the electrons get excited. That is, the electrons tend to bounce. So when an object or a person has extra electrons, that they create a negative charge. These electrons thus get attracted to positive electrons as opposite attracts of another object. The shock that we feel sometimes is the result of the quick movement of these electrons. Yes, electric charge is formed most commonly in winters and when the climate around us is dry. When air dries up, the electrons easily develop on the surface of our skin. During summers, the air moisture eradicates the negatively charged electrons and we rarely feel electric charge. Some common facts about electric discharge are: lightning is also a large form of static electricity, which is formed when air is rubbed against the cloud. Static electricity does not cause high current unless it is on the large scale like lightning. By rubbing silk or glass rod, we can create positively charged static electricity. For negatively charged static current, rub fur on plastic or rubber rod. Even the static electricity travels at the same speed of light, which is 300,000 km per second. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning everyone. My name is Sarpit Reddy. I am studying in class 8. Today I am going to say about functions of different cell organelles. We know that cell is structural and functional unit of our life. Cell have different components called cell organelles. They are endoplasmic reticulum, plastids, vacuole, ribosomes, Golgi complex, etc. Let us learn them in detail. Plastids. Plastids are only found in plant cell. They impart color to different parts of a plant. Mitochondria. Mitochondria is powerhouse of a plant because it converts digested food to energy by the process of cellular respiration. Golgi complex. Golgi complex is a process of processing and packaging the food materials. Endoplasmic reticulum. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum. They are rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum has dot-like structures called ribosomes. They help in synthesizing of proteins. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum. They involve in the process of synthesizing of fats. Vacuoles. Vacuole is a cell organelle in which it stores waste and excessive of water. Thank you. Hope you like this video.
Very good morning to one and all. This is Kavita Velappan, science teacher at DAV School, IIT Hyderabad campus. Today is National Science Day. The theme for this year is Future of Science, Technology and Innovation, Impact on Education, Skills and Work. We celebrate National Science Day to remember the discovery of Raman effect. Chandrasekhar Venkatraman was born in Tiruchirappalli in 1888. Later, he moved to Vizag for his schooling. He was a bright child. He himself called him as born with a brown spoon because his father was a school teacher earning enough money, which is just 10 rupees per month. He came back to Tamil Nadu to pursue higher education, undergraduate and post-graduation in Presidency College in Chennai. While doing MA in physics, he published his first research paper on diffraction of light at the age of 18. Later on, he qualified the Indian Audit and Account Service examination at the age of 19 and started his career as Assistant Accountant General in Kolkata. Simultaneously, he started his independent research in a nearby institute, Indian Association for the Cultivation of Science. In 1917, he was appointed as Professor of Physics in the University of Kolkata. Got an opportunity to attend a conference in Europe. He saw the blue beach in Mediterranean Sea. While returning by ship, he started analyzing the color of the sea and wrote a manuscript before he reached Bombay Harbour. His article was published in Nature under the title The Color of the Sea. He then performed a set of experiments with 60 samples to understand the pathway of light through various substances. He observed a new type of secondary radiation. Soon, he published his research in Nature. As you can see, Raman was excited on 28 February 1928 to see this effect and was proudly demonstrating this experiment to foreign delegates, where you can find his student named Krishnan who performed this experiment. To demonstrate this phenomenon, he developed a simple experimental setup which is known as Raman spectrograph. I would like to highlight the two most important applications of Raman effect: space research and medicine. On 23 February 2021, a landmark achievement in the history of space research was performed by launching Mars rover. This particular vehicle carries Raman spectrometer to analyze Mars, which is highlighted in the recently published report. The second important application is to guide brain biopsies. For his contribution to the field of science, he received Nobel Prize in Physics in the year 1930. Where are we moving? How science, technology and innovation has impacted human life? Most notable recent discoveries: energy storing bricks, robotic guides, sweat powered smartwatches, artificial neurons on silicon chips, etc. Therefore, discoveries and innovations can be generated through simple ideas. As Sir Raman says, "I am the master of my failure. If I never fail, how will I ever learn?" So, be prepared to face failures to succeed and think simply. Thank you. Have a nice day.